every chain.
Break every chain.
Come on, say it to me.
Break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain.
There's an army. Hallelujah. Rising up.
Hey, hey.
There's an army.
Hallelujah.
Rising up. There's an army.
Break every chain.
Come on, Tim, say it. There is power in the name of Jesus. Oh, there is power in the name of Jesus.
Good afternoon.
There is power in the name of Jesus. Oh, to break every chain, break every chain. Break every chain. Oh, break.
Yes, good afternoon. Good afternoon, everyone. A pleasant good afternoon to you again on Sound of Deliverance with Sister Carol. And there is still a power in the name of Jesus. I wasn't able to be here last week, but here I am again in the name of Jesus. Bless the name to proclaim the name. The name of Jesus, that there is power in the name of Jesus to break your chains.
We know where it is to break every chain, break every chain.
And this afternoon, I worship only at the feet of Jesus. And my prayer is that you will also come to worship at the feet of Jesus. Those of you who do not know the Master, that you will come to know him even today, and the power that there is in his name.
Rising up, there's an army rising up, yeah, to break every chain, break every chain.
Lord, conquering lion of the tribe of Judah, the one who sitteth upon the throne, the one who sits at the right hand of the Father, making intercession for your people, even right now, Father God. And I thank you, Lord, that through your blood, we have access to the throne of grace. We can come into your throne room, Father, to cry Abba, to find mercy and grace to help in time of our need, when we're sick or when we are sad. Oh yes, Father, when we need deliverance, we can come into your throne room, Father, and kneel at your feet, Father God, without fear, because Jesus has already made the way. There was a time, God, when we could not approach you, but oh God, through Jesus Christ, through the blood, we are able to approach you, God, through the atoning blood of Jesus Christ this afternoon. We are able to come and say, Father. We are able to come and say, Abba. We thank you for mercy. We thank you for your chesed. Oh yes, oh your haram. Oh yes, Father, your pitying love, your loving kindness, and your tender mercies that you have shown to mankind. Oh God, we do not merit any good that you could ever do for us. But we thank you for grace, the wonderful grace of Jesus that has appeared unto all men. Father, this afternoon, as at other times, I welcome your royal presence, Father God. I welcome your holy presence, hallelujah, that we may take full control, Lord Jesus. Not my will, Lord, but thine be done. Not, oh God, not my plan, oh God, but according to your plan, Father God. So let it be. I give you praise and I give you glory this afternoon. And I cry, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee, how great thou art. Father, I love you. Father, I adore you. Father, I lift you up this afternoon. I thank you for journeying mercies, Lord Jesus. I thank you, Lord, for divine protection. Not just protection, oh God, but divine protection. Special protection this afternoon, Lord Jesus. That, oh God, you have given to me. And, oh God, to your children who trust in you for guidance. To your children, oh God, who travel the roads daily. To your children, oh God, who get in their motor vehicles daily, Lord Jesus. And you keep us, Father God. And you take us safely back home, Lord Jesus. When the enemy lurks in corners. When the world lurks at the four-way stop. When they stand, oh God, with their eyes bowing down to the earth. When, oh God, they circle us, oh God, in the morning. And in the evening, they're there waiting for us. We thank you for the angels of the Lord who encamp around your children to deliver them, Father God. I bless your name this afternoon for special divine protection, for your eyes that are watching over us, for your eyes, Lord Jesus, run to and fro the whole earth to show yourself strong on the behalf of those who walk uprightly before you, Lord. Thank you for those angels who are doing their jobs, those ministering spirits that you have sent out, hallelujah, on the behalf of your children. Day and night, Lord Jesus, when we slumber, Lord, and when we are awake, your angels are there to guide us. Your angels are there to watch over us, Father God. And I do not take it lightly, Lord Jesus, for I can say this afternoon, wasn't it for you? Hadn't it been for the Lord? Oh, yes, who was on my side when men rose up against me? They would have swallowed me up quickly. They would have swallowed up your children quickly, Lord. And they would have laughed and said, ha, ha, ha. Where now is your God? You trusted in God. How come he didn't protect you? But oh God, this afternoon, I can boast in you. I can say you're God indeed. You're a God to your word. You're a protector, Lord. You're a provider. You're my peace. You're my righteousness. You're my sanctifier, Lord. You're my friend. You're a brother, Lord Jesus. Oh yes, a friend that sticks get closer than a brother. My Jesus is to me. He's my dearest friend in everything I need. Surely he's my rock. He's my shield. He's my hiding place. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for freedom of worship. But there will come a time when we'll have to hide to go to the sanctuary, or we'll have to hide our Bibles, hallelujah. Our Lord, we'll have to just pray with our lips moving and our voice not being heard, hallelujah. But oh God, hallelujah, we thank you for this freedom right now. Let us take and make opportunity and make full use, oh God, of this opportunity. All that we have right now. But there's coming a day when the church shall be persecuted. Even more so, Lord, we are persecuted now. But even more so, Lord Jesus, it is coming. For the Antichrist, oh God, he's here. Just waiting to be revealed, hallelujah. Help us, oh God, to walk circumspectly, Lord. Not as fools, but as wise. Redeeming the times, because the days are evil. Help us not to be foolish, but help us, oh God, to be as a wise virgin, to trim our lamps, and be ready for that midnight cry. For there shall come a time when you shall come, Lord Jesus. You shall put in your appearance, and those who are ready will be ready. Those those who are filthy will be filthy still. But oh God, help us not to be caught up, caught unawares, oh Lord, like a thief. But oh God, help us to be also ready. For in such an hour that we think not, the Son of Man cometh. Thank you, Lord, for Jesus, your Son. Thank you, Lord, for giving us your Son. Thank you, Lord, for coming down and walking among men. You know your touch with the feeling of our infirmities. When we cry, when we feel pain, when we are in grief, when we are in sorrow, when we are despised, when we are rejected, when we are hungry, when we are homeless, when we are friendless, when we are motherless and fatherless, hallelujah. You know, for God, you went through it. So God, when we cry, oh Lord, when we call, you understand, you are touched, hallelujah. And so this afternoon, Father, I give you praise. Thank you for the power that there is in your name, and the mighty power that there is in your blood. I pray this afternoon that your presence may take, hallelujah, preeminence, hallelujah, in the mighty name of Jesus. Not I, but Christ that dwells in me. Heal the brokenhearted. Bind up the wounds, Father God. Hallelujah. There are many who are in sorrow right now. There are many who are in grief. Hallelujah. There are many, oh God, who have not smiled or laughed in a long time. But oh God, I pray that you may turn mourning into laughter. Hallelujah. Yeah, and those who sit in the ashes. But oh God, you will clothe them. Oh yes, Lord, in the garment of praise. And those whose spirits are heavy, that oh God, you may pour your joy upon them this afternoon. Hallelujah. Set free, deliver the lonely, the brokenhearted, the bereaved, the bereft, Father God. Hear prayer this afternoon. Let those chains fall. Strengthen the hands which hung down. Hallelujah. Confirm the feeble knees. I give you praise. Yeah, Lord. Hallelujah. Yeah, Lord. Hallelujah. Yeah, Lord. Hallelujah. I give you worship. Hallelujah. For that pleasure, I was created. Hallelujah. For that pleasure, Lord, I was born. So I give you worship this afternoon, for you are worthy. You are worthy. I lift you up. I exalt you, Lord. I adore you, Father God. I magnify your name. I lift my hands and my heart, hallelujah, in total adoration to you, Father. Take my lips. Oh God, let them speak as an oracle of yours. Not, oh God, anything that I might have planned, but, oh God, according to thus saith the Lord, hallelujah, accept me. Yes, Lord, I am nothing, but I pray that you may wash, that you may purge, that you may cleanse, and you may bathe. Wash me without within, purge with fire, if that must be, that your will may be, Lord Jesus, that I may do your will, and that I may be what you have called me to be, that I may do, Lord Jesus, your will, hallelujah, with a heart sincere, not for my glory, but, oh God, for your glory. Hear and bless, sanctify, keep, deliver, Lord, and turn things around for those who need a turning around in their lives. I give you honor, and I say thank you in the name of Jesus. nor the name but the name of the Lord, that name that is worthy of honor, that name that is worthy of glory, that name that is worthy of power and all praise. Thanks be to you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Bless the name. Bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to the name of the Lord. For you alone, you alone, you alone, you alone, Adonai Echad. You alone, hallelujah. One God, I bless your name this afternoon. Glory to the name. Glory to the name. Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus. Glory, 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 glory. To the name of the King of Kings. Hallelujah. To the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. To the King. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Glory to God. Glory to God. It's good to be here with you this afternoon. I pray that whatever might be said this afternoon, that it will be something that you needed to hear, that it will be a blessing and a comfort to your soul, that it will bring deliverance in your life. May God bless you this afternoon. You're in tune to the sound of deliverance.
Can I get an amen
on Choice Radio?
Can I get an amen on
92.9
the Bible
FM?
Records in Matthew,
your life,
chapter 2, and
your
three.
Salvation, your choice.
It says, when the wise
choose Jesus.
Came,
choose life this afternoon.
Jesus was,
that you
it says, when
might live
him,
in abundance.
Fell down,
for he came
and
for us
him.
To have life.
Everybody say,
not
down.
Just life, but
down,
abundant life.
They worshipped him, and the scripture
may you
says,
be blessed.
And then,
in the name of Jesus.
Their treasures were opened, and they presented unto him gifts. And therein is a glorious revelation of the Spirit. And it is this, that when you and I will humble ourselves and begin to worship the treasure that is in this earthen vessel begins to open up. Somebody say yes. And the gifts of the Spirit of God that are within us begin to flow. I believe if we will worship God with our whole heart, our whole spirit and soul, God's presence and power will begin to move in this place. People can be healed and delivered even while we're worshiping and recording. Does anybody believe that with me? I want you to lift up your hands now and begin to lift up your voices. That's right. Just begin to open your own mouth and begin to worship him. Out of your spirit, just begin to bless his holy name. If he's done anything for you, just begin to worship. Worship. Begin to bless his name. Begin to bless his name. Come on and bless his name. Come on, worship.
Bow down and worship him. Worship him.
I will extol thee,
oh, worship
my
him.
God, O King. I will bless thy name forever and ever. Every day will I bless thee, and I will praise thy name forever and ever. Great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised, and his greatness is unsearchable. One generation shall praise thy works to another, and shall declare thy mighty acts. I will speak of the glorious honor of thy majesty, and of thy wondrous works, and men shall speak of the might of thy terrible acts, and I will declare thy greatness. They shall abundantly utter the memory of thy great goodness and shall sing of thy righteousness. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and of great mercy. The Lord is good to all, and his tender mercies are over all his works. All thy works shall praise thee, O Lord, and thy saints shall bless thee. They shall speak of the glory of thy kingdom and talk of thy power, to make known to the sons of men his mighty acts and the glorious majesty of his kingdom. Thy kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and thy dominion endureth throughout all generations. The Lord upholdeth all that fall, and raiseth up all those that be bowed down. The eyes of all wait upon thee, and thou givest them their meat in due season. Thou openest thine hand, and satisfy the desire of every living thing. The Lord is righteous in all his ways and holy in all his works. The Lord is nigh unto all that call upon him. To all that call upon him in truth, he will fulfill the desire of them that fear him. He also will hear their cry, and he will save them. The Lord preserveth all them that love him, but all the wicked he will destroy. My mouth shall speak the praise of the Lord, and let all flesh bless his holy name forever and ever. The word of the Lord, bow down and worship him, for he's worthy.
Promised us, but as as I climbed, the promise faded, and when blue lonely through the night, so I'll worship only at the feet
of the kingdom.
Then shall the kingdom of heaven be likened unto 10 virgins, which took their lamps and went forth to meet the bridegroom. And 5 of them were wise, and 5 were foolish. They that were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them. But the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. While the bridegroom tarried, they all slumbered and slept. And at midnight there was a cry made, "Behold, the bridegroom cometh, go ye out to meet him." Then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said unto the wise, "Give us up your oil, for our lamps are gone out." But the wise answered, saying, "Not so, lest there be not enough for us and you. But go ye rather to them that sell and buy for yourselves." And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and they that were ready went in with him to the marriage, and the door was shut. Afterward there also came other virgins, saying, "Lord, Lord, open to us." But he answered and said, "Verily I say unto you, I know you not. Watch therefore, for ye know not neither the day nor the hour wherein the Son of Man cometh." The word of the Lord. This parable, of course, is about the second coming of the Lord. The songwriter says, "What a beautiful day for the Lord to come again." It is indeed a beautiful day in New York. But if the Lord should come now on this beautiful day, will you be ready? Will you be among the wise virgins or the foolish? The Lord has placed it on my heart to speak these words again. I have observed something terribly wrong with believers today. And it is that most of us, some of us are among the foolish virgins, because we are not watching, we are not ready, our lamps are not trimmed, our wick are not trimmed, our lights are going out. The shade of the lamp is becoming blackened, darkened, because the wick is not trimmed. The wick is burning out, and all that is coming from it is blackness, just smoke. Will you be ready? Will you be prepared to meet the bridegroom? There is a need to be prepared at all times for this great event. The coming of the bridegroom is none other than Yeshua HaMashiach, the Messiah. I will stress that. Yeshua HaMashiach, the Messiah, Jesus Christ, the Anointed One, the King of Kings, and the Lord of Lords, the conquering lion of the tribe of Judah, the King of the Jews, the King of the whole earth, the King of all humankind, of every race, every tribe, and every kindred. Jesus is. He is the bridegroom, and he will be coming soon. Are you prepared? Some say, "Since I was a boy, since I was a girl, since I was a child, since my eyes were at my knees, I heard that Jesus is coming. Where is he?" But the word of God says, "Watch, For he shall come as a thief in the night. For if you knew when the thief was coming, you would have watched. If we knew when the thief were coming, we would have all watched. We'd have sat by the door or the window with some kind of weapon. So because we do not know the day or the hour, we are admonished this afternoon to watch. There is a need for constant watchfulness, church. For no one knows the moment of our Lord's coming. Since we do not know the day nor the hour, we must be always ready. One songwriter says, will you be ready when Jesus comes? Are you truly born again and washed in his blood? Are your garments spotless and are they whiter than snow? Will you be ready when Jesus comes? We are the church. And like virgins, we are awaiting the bridegroom. Some are wise, some are foolish. They diligently prepare themselves for the master's coming, heeding the call to grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. The day of the Lord's coming will be a day of judgment upon the earth, the entire earth, the entire world, and every eye shall see him. Every eye shall behold him face to face. Some will run away from him. Some will call on the rocks to hide us from the wrath of the Lamb. But some will be caught up together with him in the clouds to reign with him in his kingdom here on earth. Are you among the wise, or are you playing the fool this afternoon? Christ's second coming will be sudden and terrifying for those who do not believe. Terrifying for unbelievers. But if we are ready and prepared, morally clean and spiritually alert, it won't be surprising or terrible. Peter tells us that the earth shall be burnt up, and we should put our confidence only in what is lasting and eternal, and not to be bound to earth in its treasures or in its pursuits. Many spend their time today laying up treasures on earth for themselves, piling up, laying up possessions. Is that what you're doing this afternoon? Buying and shopping and splurging and living high on the hogs. And have forgotten that there's a great and terrible day coming, a day of reckoning, when every man shall stand before the judgment seat of Christ to give an account of the deeds done in his body, whether it be good or whether it be evil. Do you spend more time piling up or laying up possessions, or are you striving to develop Christ-like character, church? For those prepared virgins, the coming of the Lord will be a blessing. Yes. This afternoon, as I said, there is something that is really bothering me about the church. We are sleeping. Our lamps have run out. Our oil have run out. We're spending more time in pleasure, more time on our jobs, more time about our own business, more time in playing and having fun more time talking about what we have and what we're going to do and what we want to be. And there's no time spent with Jesus. Just 5 minutes, 15 minutes, and if some of us were spending 15 minutes, it would have been good. But we're all slumbering. Some of us are slumbering. We are sleeping. We are drunk with sleep. We have no time to pray. Some are foolish. They know that the Lord is coming, but they are not prepared. We are admonished this afternoon to be faithful and to be wise and to carry out our Christian responsibilities and our relationship with our brethren and the body of Christ. We are admonished this afternoon to pray. There's a song that says, pray without ceasing. Let's pray every day. Prayer will help you every step of the way. Jesus is willing to hear and to bless you, to answer you. Pray without ceasing. Let's pray every day. Let's watch, for in watching or in praying, we are watching. If we are not praying, my friends, we are not watching. If we are not praying, we are foolish. Our lamps are black. The shade of our lamps is black, clouded. Our wicks have gone down, burnt out. Are you one of those foolish virgins this afternoon? For what shall it profit a man if he should gain the whole world and lose his soul? A little slumber and a little sleep will make us go to hell. Let us watch. My friends, are you prepared to meet the bridegroom? Is a question this afternoon. We should be also trustworthy, honest, and truthful. Don't tell a little lie here, a little lie there, and take it for granted. That's a part of being watchful, living the life of honesty, living a trustworthy life, living uprightly, living truthfully before the Lord and among ourselves as brethren. It's a part of being watchful. It's a part of being wise. In summary, whoever is entrusted with duties, brethren, let us not be like the unwise servants who put away because they thought the Lord wasn't there, Lord was not coming back anytime soon. They idled. But let us be trustworthy people, trustworthy brethren, trustworthy servants. In summary, whoever is entrusted with duties must perform them faithfully. We must be faithful, wise, and ready virgins. We have been warned by Jesus of what will happen to such evil servants. So we're talking of the evil servants also. And we can read in Matthew 24, 50 to 51 in your spirit time. What did he say? Weeping and wailing and gnashing of teeth will happen to those who are not ready, to those who have not used wisely what the Master gave to them, to those who are not watchful, to those of us believers who are not prayerful, to those of us believers who find more time to talk and to gossip about each other. There will be weeping and gnashing of teeth, teeth knocking together. And someone said, if you don't have teeth, then the gums will gnash or will knock together. And I believe that those of us who don't have teeth when Jesus comes, all the teeth will come back together. And all who were not in the right mind when they died, everyone will be in the right mind at the judgment seat of righteousness. Because God is going to question you about your works, about your deeds, all that you did, how you spurned the gospel, how you laughed and mocked and derided and criticized. God is going to judge you on that day. He's going to judge you because you were not watchful. He's going to judge you because you were not prayerful. He's going to judge you because you were unwise. We must be faithful and ready. What will happen to the evil servants? The word of God says they'll be weeping and wailing, gnashing of teeth. What will happen to the unwise, the foolish virgins? They'll be weeping and wailing and gnashing of teeth. Gnashing of teeth speaks of despair, a day of darkness, a day of gloominess, a day of desperation, a day when there'll be no mercy. For that day when the Lord shall have left his throne, mercy will have left. There'll be no mercy to come running anymore. There'll be no mercy to come run and plead our case. Because mercy will have left the throne room. Hallelujah to the name of the Lord. Are you like those wise virgins? Or are you the foolish ones? There's a great day coming. A great day coming. Yes. Are you ready for that great and terrible day? Joel said a day of darkness, a day of gloominess. The sun shall be turned. The moon shall be turned into blood on that day. Are you ready for the judgment day? Are you a wise virgin? Are you watchful? It's the question. Are you prepared to meet the bridegroom? Are you forming the fool in church? Are you forming the fool in front of God or before God? Are you making a mockery? You take this thing for a joke. I heard a song when I was a little girl, says time is longer than rope. You take it for a joke. One day, that rope will become shortened. There'll be nothing left to hold on to. Time will become short. There'll be no more time. Time would have run out. What will your answer be on that day? And I'm speaking to the church. And I'm also speaking to sinners this afternoon. Are you prepared? Are you prepared, sinners? This is also for you. But more so for the church this afternoon, who is lingering. The church who is idle. It must be time for the waiting church to cast her pride away with girded loins and burning lamps to be ready for the breaking of the day. Oh, it must be the breaking of the day. The night is almost gone. The day is coming on. It must be the breaking of the day. Are you prepared to meet the bridegroom? We should not trust in our previous accomplishments. The foolish virgins did. They did have some oil. And they thought, oh, well, what I have is enough. It will last. They weren't watching. They did not notice that their oil was going down. They did have some oil. So they made some preparation, of course. but they foolishly trusted in what they had done in the past. They foolishly trusted in the amount that they had. They said, this will do. It's going down, but I think. We cannot say we think. We have to be sure. We have to be certain. They trusted in what they had done in the past. We should never rest on laurels, but we should be like the Apostle Paul. In Philippians 3, 12 to 15, Paul said, his goal was to know Christ, to be like him. We should never allow anything to distract us from the reaching or achieving or a goal in Christ, from being watchful. Paul said, I count all things but dung, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward to the things that are before. Paul said, I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus my Lord. He said, for whom I've suffered the loss of all things and do count them but dung, nothing, garbage, worthless, that I may win Christ. He said, that I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his suffering. I cast those things behind my back, and I prefer to suffer with him or for him, that I may reign with him in the end. Are you prepared to meet the bridegroom? What is holding you back? What is keeping you back? What is it that has made you stagnant, lackadaisical, lazy, unprayerful, unholy, ungodly, covetous, heady, high-minded, proud, knowing nothing? What is it? Do you think when Jesus comes, he's going to give you a pat on the back or on the shoulder and say, okay, my child, I know you were weak. Come on. Welcome home, my child. Come on in. No, he will say, depart from me, you worker of iniquity. I do not know you, never met you, never see you before in my life. I know nothing about you. Depart from me. Is that what you want to hear? Because some of us who claim that we are serving God, our hands are full of iniquity. Our feet have shed innocent blood. Our hands have shed innocent blood. And our feet have run into mischief. We lie. We steal. We do everything that the word of God says thou shalt not do. And we come and sit up in the face of God as if we are right and holy, just and good, as if we are ready. Will you be ready when Jesus comes to reward his servant, whether it be noon or night, faithful to him? Will he find you watching with your lamp all trimmed and bright? Oh, can you say you're ready, brother, sister? Ready for the soul's bright home? Will he find you watching? What is holding you back? Have you prepared to meet the bridegroom? Paul had reason to forget what he had left behind. He had a sorrowed past. Some of us, we have left our sorrowed past, but you want to pick it up again? Like a hog to its vomit and a dog to its wallow. Is that where you're headed? Do you want to return to your old sinful nature? He had a sorrowed past. He was a persecutor of the church of God. He was a murderer. God says this afternoon, do not dwell on the past. Instead, grow in the knowledge of God by concentrating on your relationship with Him now. Are you foolishly depending on what you had done in the past? I used to be this and I used to be that. The past is gone. The past is over. If it's your past, something in your past that you did, that you're still holding on to, that is keeping you from being watchful, from being prayerful, because every time you kneel down to pray, it comes before you. The Bible says, if you confess your sins, or if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive and to cleanse from all unrighteousness. He says He casts our sins behind His back. So if you came to Him and you confessed all your wrongs, even if you were a murderer, and you confessed all of that to Him, and you yielded your stubborn will to Him, and everything that pertains to self, you did yield to Christ, then why should it hold you back? Why are you going back to the past? And if you're in church, and you were once on fire for God, and now you're silent and numb and glum and dull, it won't work. It can't help. Used to be. Don't count anymore, someone said. They just stay on the floor till you sweep them away. I used to be this in the church. That won't do anymore. How are you now? Are you ready now? Are your wicks trimmed and prepared for the coming of the bridegroom? Is there oil in your lamp? Once in a while, it says a little more oil, or give me more oil in my lamp that I may keep it burning. Keep it burning till the break of day. When will be the break of day? We do not know. But we certainly know that when the bridegroom comes and we are going out to meet him, we need to have our lamps trimmed and ready. We need to have our lamps held up, burning bright. For if it's not filled with oil or trimmed, we will stumble. And if you're stumbling when Jesus comes, it means you're going nowhere with him. You will not be reigning with him. Is there oil in your lamp? It's a question this afternoon. Preparedness is not transferable. The wise virgins could not share their oil with the foolish virgins. Nor can we impart what salvation we have received to someone else. You got to know Jesus for yourself. You got to go out there and get your lamp filled for yourself. You got to have your own testimony for yourself. You can't depend on someone else. Preparedness, it's not transferable. The wise virgins could not share their oil with the foolish virgins. Nor can we impart what salvation we have received to someone. You must receive it from the Lord yourself. Eternal life cannot be bought. Only God can redeem the soul. The songwriter says, nor silver nor gold has obtained my redemption. No riches of earth could have saved my poor soul. The blood of the cross is my only foundation. The death of my Savior could only atone. The death of my Savior could only atone. I am redeemed, but not with silver. I am bought, but not with gold. Bought with the price, the precious blood of Jesus, precious price of love untold. Proverbs 9, verse 12 tells us in sum and substance that the wise will reap the benefits of wisdom. Are you that wise? Benefit of wisdom. Entrance into the kingdom of God. One can never be saved by association. Or do we think we can be saved by association? My mother is a Christian, my husband, my father is a pastor. So I think I'll be able to make it in. No, we have to come to know Christ for ourselves. Each must have our own name in the book of life. God will not say, so this is the daughter of so and so. I'm going to put your name next to your mother or your father. Not by association. Each must have his own name written in the book of life. Revelation 20:12-15, and the dead were judged out of those things written in the book of life, according to their works. According to your works. We get up each day and we go labor for the man out there. We go labor for the boss. But what we do for Christ, what we do in his name, is our works. Feed the hungry, clothe the naked, take care of each other, live right, be holy, walk uprightly, be kind, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, taking care of each other, our works. Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. The word of God says, from henceforth, they rest from their labor. Rest from the labor. Rest from going out and catching the train in the mornings. From rush hour traffic. Rest from their labor and their works do follow them. The deeds of kindness, of love, and of mercy, their works. Rest from labor. Rest from going to catch the bus, standing at the bus stop in the snowy morning, in 14 degrees weather. Labor. Works. Kind, tender-hearted, forgiving one another. Doing the work of the Lord. Seeking those who are astray. Saving souls along the way. Their works do follow them. If we are not working, emphasizing loyalty to the Lord and his way, making every effort to overcome Satan and the world, and the self-centeredness within us, and resisting all of our being, or with all of our beings, the temptations. All those temptations, all that is to do with the natural and the carnal. If we are not using our energy and spending our time working out our own salvation, it is very likely then that we are not going to have the character necessary to go to the grave. If we are not doing good deeds, if we are being carnal, if we are not resisting temptations, if we are yielding to temptation and to sin, if we are not using our energy and spending our time working out our own salvation, it is very likely that we are not going to have the character necessary to go to the grave. Because whatever you are when you die, that is what you will be when the trumpet sounds. There is no repentance in the grave, and you cannot be prayed out of purgatory. It is a lie. It is deception. Only Jesus Christ can forgive sins. Call no man on earth Father. God alone is Father. He alone has the power to forgive sins. The word of God. So if you're confessing your sin to man, you're packed up with sin, you're still full of sin, you have not been forgiven. Confess your sins to Jesus. He's faithful and just to forgive and to cleanse you from all unrighteousness. See, if you die a righteous soul, when you rise on that great day, you will be righteous. If you were filthy and did not accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, and kept the way, and live right and holy, and you die and you're unholy, when the trumpet blows, you will be unholy, and you will be going to hell. The word of God. And if you were once righteous, and you turn away from your righteous ways, and begin to do wickedness, and you die, you're going to hell. You will not see the bridegroom, the word of the Lord. The wrong works will follow us, and we will not be prepared for the kingdom of God. So if your works are evil, now on earth, your hands are evil and dirty, mischievous, iniquity, and all these things that the Bible speaks that thou shalt not do, and you're doing them, and you call yourself a believer. And if you're a sinner out there listening this afternoon, and your works are unrighteous, you will not see the bridegroom when he comes. I'm speaking of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, King of kings and Lord of lords, conquering lion of the tribe of Yehuda, Judah, King of the Jews, Messiah, Yeshua, HaMashiach. That is whom I'm speaking of. One Jesus, one Lord. One Lord. There's no more Messiah but Jesus Christ. There's no more Messiah but Yeshua, HaMashiach. The one who came, he was born in a manger. He did not come in pomp and circumstance. He did not come dressed in a kingly robe, riding on a white horse. He was born in a feeding trough. Lowly, humble, he came. Yes, he came for all. From the pauper to the prince, he came for everybody. So if he had come as a king, I would not be part and participant of his kingdom. A poor pheasant. He didn't want me in his kingdom because he's a rich old king. He came so rich in pomp and circumstance. So when I kneel to him, he pushed me away because I'm not a princess. He came lowly. There was no room for him at the hotel. At the motel, the hospitals were full. No place for him. So he had to turn around his mother and go into a stable, a manger, and had him in a feeding trough. Jesus of Nazareth, he became poor and lowly that we might be rich. Not necessarily in the things of this world, but in faith and hope and love, in the things of the kingdom. Yes, he came poor, but this time he'll be coming, riding on a white horse, and the sash across his chest will read, King of Kings and Lord of Lords, conquering lion of the tribe of Yehuda. So those who are looking for a Messiah to come, And it is not Jesus. You have been deceived. You are being fooled. You are blind. Open your eyes and see that Jesus has already come. Came as a baby. He's coming now as a prince, a king, a frowning judge, to reward every man according to his work. So if you do not believe in this bridegroom that I'm speaking about, and if you're not prepared to meet this bridegroom of whom I speak, then your end will be everlasting destruction. The foolish virgins went out. They got their oil, but it was too late. Too late, too late will be the cry. Jesus of Nazareth has passed by. You mocked, you derided, you persecuted those who believe in Jesus. Yes. When they said Jesus, you came after them with vengeance to destroy them. La kurundi libiu shukura rabasha mandi rabosha kanda reseti kutura maresendili abarasa kito romundi libiai shendura barasiodo nenia nenia namalise teli adalda lutese teti lendi alalibo lebondi libiu shukura baresendi rabosha lebendo roboshema. There will be a great day coming. A great day coming. Yes. Are you ready? Are you ready to meet the Lord? Are you ready to meet Yeshua? King of Kings. Shebeviasiliandiedosiela. Resendi alla bastendo rabassata, ribia e la cora marandi alla baha, ribussiti di ambindi alla munda la bassandi alla bocca da, rabondi bia balassala, shekurundi, yebolo shaba, yekumuasha, rubushi bia, kiria mahasanta liabolindia, you mock, you deride, yekurubwa, you persecute, you lay in wait, takito rinia nasata, eteke tebelesada, to catch the children of God, those who call upon the name of Jesus, and those who have the testimony of Jesus Christ. Ha ha, shekuma, shima, shaba. What will your answer be on that day? Ha ha, will you run to meet him, ha-ha, or will you run away and cry, fall on us, the rocks, hide us from the wrath of the Lamb, ha-ha. The word of God said they shall look upon him whom they have pierced, and they shall weep, ha-ha, as one that weepeth for an only son. Are you prepared to meet the bridegroom? What a person has done. That is, what he has worked on in his lifetime follows him through the grave, either into the lake of fire or into the kingdom of God. There's no repentance in the grave. Are you foolishly trusting in your relationship with someone else for salvation? A parent? A spouse? Church? Religious affiliation? Who is your God? Who are you praying to? Are you worshiping only at the feet of Jesus? Are you bowing to wood, stone, silver and gold? Your job, your position, your possession in life. Who is your God? Are you prepared to meet the bridegroom, Yeshua, Jesus, when he comes? If you're unprepared, there are no second chances. Despite the pleas of the foolish virgins, they were not permitted to enter the wedding. It's in Matthew 25. And if you have not been reading the Old Testament, get to it. Begin to read the Old Testament. Get to it, for there's a great day coming. Jesus of Nazareth, Yeshua, is coming again. They were not prepared to enter the wedding ceremony when the Lord shall appear again. The time for salvation will come to an end. St. Luke 21, 26. St. Luke 21, 36. That day of salvation. Yes, time to be saved, to cry, to weep, and say, Lord, have mercy. That day will be over. Watch ye therefore, and pray always. We must maintain a state of preparedness. Be careful not to allow the world to preoccupy you. St. Luke chapter 21, 34 to 35. Let the world not preoccupy you through its worldly lust, through its worldly concerns, cares, and surfeiting. Be steadfast in prayer. St. Luke 21, 36. For in prayer we naturally maintain an attitude of watchfulness. If you're prayerful, then you're watchful. And that's a mark of preparation. Ephesians 6:18 tells us to put on the old armor. Put it on. Keep it on. It's not an armor you can take off when you go to the shower, when you go to bed. It must always be worn by the believer. Put on, keep it on. The old armor, W-H-O-L-E. The whole armor of God. And be watchful according to the word of God. Make prayer your life. Pray always. Pray constantly. Pray without ceasing. Make it your life. Make prayer your life. And your life a prayer. While living in a world that needs God's powerful influence, make prayer your life. Pray, always pray. The Holy Spirit pleads within thee all thy daily, hourly needs. Whatever you need, pray. And God will grant you your heart's desire. Be diligent to grow in grace. And in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ, 2 Peter 3:18. It tells of the virtues. That is 2 Peter 3:18 and 2 Peter 1:5-8. It tells of the virtues that will produce a well-rounded Christian. Fruitful Christian. Well-rounded, fruitful Christian. And by that, we will be able to live a well-rounded, fruitful Christian life if we follow the word of God. The word of God is our guide, our lamp unto our feet, and a light unto our path. These blessings that we read of in 2 Peter 1:5 to 8, they will. And they're also described in 2 Peter 1:10 to 11. By producing these fruits, we can read it in our spare time. Everlasting life is promised to us. So 2 Peter 3:18, we can read that. 2 Peter 1:5 to 8. 2 Peter 1:10 to 11. Read that. Our guide to being sober, to enter or to gain entrance into the kingdom of heaven, to ensure that you have everlasting life. There is a great day coming, a day in which those in the kingdom today will find themselves in two groups. If you're in the kingdom today, you will find yourself, if you're prepared and have fully watched for its coming, you will find yourself on the right hand of the Father. Those who have not prepared, the goats, you will find yourself the wanderer who continues to wander, who continues to be stubborn. You will find yourself on the left hand of the shepherd. Those who have prepared themselves and have faithfully watched for his coming will find themselves on the right side, will find themselves in the kingdom of God. And if you have not prepared, you will hear, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, I know you not. Depart from me into everlasting punishment." If he were to come at the dawn or midnight or even now, would he find you watching? Would he find you prepared? What will you be doing when he comes? Will you be watching? Dancing with the stars? Revenge? NFL football? Scandal? The soaps? I've even heard Christians say, "I can't afford to miss my soap." But on that day when he comes, that soap will have no use to you. It will not be able to wash away your sin. If he comes and finds you watching soap opera, that soap will not be able to wash, or any soap for that matter. It will be too late. God is calling on the church to watch. Would you know that he's here? Or will you be still there sitting down watching your soap? Are you going to be there at the great marriage supper of the Lamb with your wedding garment on? Will you meet your loved ones gone at the great marriage supper of the Lamb? It's a question. Have you prepared to meet the bridegroom? Are you going to be there with your wedding garment on? Will you meet the bridegroom at the great marriage supper of the Lamb, Church of God? Will you be shining in bright array, standing proudly in front of the Master or before the Master because you made it in? Because you were invited to the wedding feast. Prepare to go the distance. Salvation means everything, or it does nothing. Is your all on the altar? Everything, or it does you nothing. Those who are saved endure, and those who endure are saved. Those who are saved endure. Fight the fight. Continue in the fight. Stay in the fight. Don't throw your towels in. Get on the glory road. Stay on the glory road. And if you endure to the end, you shall be saved. Trim your wicks and be ready while there is time. The foolish virgins went to get their oil replenished. When they returned, the doors were closed. They were not at the wedding, and so they were lost. Will you be ready when Jesus comes? How full is your vessel? Are you completely focused on your salvation? If you know what it takes to enter the kingdom of God, will you do what you must? Will you do what you must do? Accept Jesus Christ today and the church. Will you do what you must do? Will you watch? Will you be prayerful? Will you change your habit? Will you change your lifestyle? Let there be a turnaround for you. Become prayerful. Become devoted. Set apart a time for devotion. Stop falling asleep on your knees. Stop making, telling the Lord, Lord, I'm going to wake up at 10. When 10 comes, say 11, 12, 1. Okay, the time passes by. You never prayed. And when you get up, you say, Lord of mercy, you understand. He does not understand. He said, pray always with all prayer and supplication. And it's pray because you do not know. Watch because you do not know the hour when he comes. If you know what it takes to enter the kingdom of God, will you do it? Do what you must. The songwriter says, we shall praise him by the crystal tide. When the lamb that was slain is glorified, and the ransom, the redeemed, the bought church of God shall be the bride at the great marriage supper of the Lamb. Are you going to be there? Blessed are those who are called to the marriage supper of the Lamb. Blessed are those who are called to the marriage supper of the Lamb. Revelation 22:15. Are you going to be there? Are your wicks trimmed? Are you prayerful? Are you watchful? Begin to pray again, Church of God. We have lost our prayer lives. We are idle. We are sleeping. Yes, we have become lazy and lackadaisical. Anything to do with the work of the Lord, with prayer, we stumble and we fumble. But when it's our own business, we're up and about, out, we're gone. I'm coming now. But it comes to being prayerful and being watchful. Are you going to be there at the great marriage supper of the Lamb? Or are you going to be left out of the kingdom of God because you were not watchful? You were not prayerful. Idle. Cannot afford to be idle, my friends. Church of God, we cannot afford. People of God, children of God, brethren, the called out. Let us know what is happening. Let us be sober. Let us be vigilant. The devil is beating us up and we don't even know it. We're calling it something else. But it's the devil that is preventing us. The Bible says, hold on to your crown and let no man take it from you. So if you're not watchful and you're not prayerful, you will lose that crown. You will lose your reward. Let us hold on to our crowns. Let not anyone, or let no man, let nothing take it away from us. That goes for me. And that goes to all who are listening, everyone who is listening this afternoon, who is a believer and have found that your prayer life is being bombarded by the forces of evil, iniquity, the forces of hell. Rise up! Rise up! as one united front and march forward in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Church of God, march forward in the power of the Holy Ghost. I say this afternoon, Church of God, march forward in the power of the Holy Ghost. For Jesus is the same. He's able to save, to keep to the utmost. He's able to preserve. Awake, arise, your lamps of purpose stream. Your Savior speak. Across the night of sorrow, as he spoke to his disciples, can he not watch one little hour with me? One little hour for watching with the Master. Eternal years of calm and peaceful rest. Watch, for we know not the hour in which the Master cometh, the bridegroom cometh. Will you be ready? Will you be prepared when the bridegroom comes? Prepare to meet your God. Watch. Jesus says, what I say to one, I say to all. Watch. 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 Watch, brethren. Watch, believer. Church of God, get serious. Watch. Get on the ball. Get on the glory road. And watch in the name of Jesus. God bless you. Bless you as you make the effort to begin to watch. Trim your lamps and be ready for the midnight cry. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Be alert. Be alert. Be alert. Watch. Be prepared. Be prepared for his coming. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah.
I don't wanna be left out. I don't wanna be left out. Jesus has prepared for us. I am thinking of a beautiful city. Oh, that beautiful city.
Beautiful. the songs upon the
Will the trumpet be the next sound that you hear? On that day, the trumpet shall sound. The dead in Christ shall rise first. We which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with him in the clouds. We shall reign with him in his kingdom here on earth forever and ever. Will that be a beautiful day for you? Or will it be a sad day for you? Are you ready? The words went forth, the questions went forth. Are you ready to meet the Lord? If you should pass away now, will you be ready to meet him? Will you be ready? What is your focus this afternoon? To the things of this world that will dim and lose their value. That the things that can become moth-eaten, corrupted and rusty, and stolen by thieves. Is that your focus? My things, my toys, my house, my car, my money, my prestige, my position, my possession. Are you watching for the coming of the Master? Are you wise or are you foolish? Bless the Lord.
The sunset, oh blissful morning, when we, oh Savior, heaven is begun.
Will it be heaven for you? Will it be joy for you on that day, beyond the sunset, when you die? If you should die now, what kind of works have you produced? Will it be good works or bad works that will follow you beyond the sunset? Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I thank you, Lord, for your words. You are true, you are faithful. Your words are yea and they are amen. You're not a man to lie or the son of man to repent what you have said, that you will do on what you have spoken. You will bring to pass. And your word says, God, if we are watchful and prayerful in that day, and our lamps or wicks are trimmed and ready and burning bright, when you come, Lord, we shall be a part of the wedding party. But oh God, if we are found lacking, then oh God, hell will be our portion. Help us all, Father, to be watchful, for we know not the hour or the day when you shall appear. But oh God, we are sure, and I am sure, and I believe, according to your word, that you shall come again as King of Kings and Lord of Lords, riding on a white horse to take from the world those who have trusted in you, those whose lamps are trimmed and burning bright. There will come a day when the kingdoms of this world shall become the kingdoms of our Lord and of his Christ. And he shall reign forever and ever. And we shall reign with you forever, Lord Jesus. Your people comfort themselves, ourselves, with these words this afternoon. And we do look forward to your coming, Lord. We say, Maranatha. Yeah, hallelujah. Even so, come, Lord Jesus, come. Oh, I long to see you just to look upon your face. Here to sing forever, there to sing forever of your saving grace. On the streets of glory, I lift my voice and I'll worship you. And I'll sing and we will sing, hallelujah, with the angels, Lord Jesus. 1,000 hallelujahs, 10,000 of hallelujahs to Jesus Christ our King. You're the hope of all who seek and the help of all who find. Another is so loving, so good and kind, hallelujah. I know that you live, oh God, at the right hand of the Father right now. But oh God, there's coming a day when you shall leave and mercy shall have run out. There'll be no more mercy. Help us to be watchful. Help us to be prayerful. Help us to be sober. Help us to be vigilant. Help us to be prepared to meet the bridegroom. Go before me now, Lord. Remove every barrier, loose every chain. Thank you for your words, which are true and faithful. Your words that are spirit and life. And help us to take heed according to our ways. For you said, oh God, what that the Lord require of thee but to do justly. What do you require? But for us to do justly, to love mercy, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with our God, to be watchful, to be prayerful, to be sober, to be alert, to be vigilant, to have our lamps trimmed and ready, so that when you come, Father, we will not be weeping and howling and looking upon you, because we are guilty. But oh God, to Lord Jesus, to embrace you, for you to say to us, come ye blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundations of the world, because you were watchful, because you were prayerful, and because your lamps are burning bright. Have mercy upon your people now. Revive your work in the midst of a year. Let, oh God, your church be filled with your glory in these last days, even as the waters cover the sea. That there will be no more, oh God, foolish virgins, but, oh God, will be wise unto salvation. Thank you for your blessings. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your mercies. Thank you for second chances. And for a second chance. Oh God, we know not the hour of the day when we shall depart from this life, but help us to be so ready. Go before me now, Lord, that your will be done in my life as ordained from the foundations of the world. Bless and touch your people once again. Bless this station. Provide for a God. Glory is coming, and it won't be long. Let us not, O God, become castaways, lest when we preach the gospel, lest when we bring the word or minister, we ourselves become a castaway. But, O God, we look forward to that day, and we shall hear, come, ye blessed, come and inherit, come reign with me, come live with me, come rule with me. In my kingdom, all glory, all praise, and honor be to you, Father, for you're always worthy. In Jesus' mighty name, in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, in the name of the Messiah, the name of Adonai Echad, I pray and say thanks. We pray and God deliver. We pray and God answer. Elishama, the God who hears and answers. Amen and amen. Hallelujah.
Use your key, use your key.
There is power.
Thank you.
In the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus to break every chain.
Thank you for listening. And may God bless you until next time. If I don't see you again this side of life, well, I'll meet you in the kingdom of God.
Come on, tell me, say.
Because I am prepared and I'm ready. Hope you will be also prepared and ready. I must make it in. Above all, I must be saved. And I hope you can say the same thing this afternoon. Remember, there is power in the name of Jesus. This is Choice Radio, 92.9 FM. Your life, your salvation, your choice. Choose to be a wise virgin this afternoon. God bless you.
Break every chain.
That's it, there is power.
There is power.
Come on.
In the name of Jesus.
Come on, you declare it.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
There is power.
There is power.
To break every chain,
break every chain.
Come on, say to
break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
There's an army rising up. There's an army rising.
There is power.
Come on.
In the name of Jesus.
You make me well. And save your soul from hell. What more do you want him to do? Thank you, Jesus. Listen, church, in this world we live in, we have trials. Yes,
oh, yes.
We do. But if we only keep the faith, he'll take us through. Yes, he will. Keep trusting.
Oh, yes.
In his name. Shame. What more do you want him to do? Thank you, Jesus.
What more do you want him to do?
Thank you, Jesus.
To
take care of your body. If you don't take care of yourself, who will take care of you? So get Dr. Robert Brand Blood and Body Bitters. Dr. Robert's Red Blood Tonic fights off fat, cholesterol, itchy skin, and it nourishes the body to improve blood circulation. Liverjin and Bynum-Amar contributes to keep the liver and blood healthy from toxin and the effects of diabetic and blood pressure medicines. Get Nervogen Tonic Powder, which helps to strengthen the nerves, brains, muscles, and even fosters better sleep. Dr. Robert's Diabetic Tonic helps to reduce blood sugar. Dr. Robert's brand flaxseed oil capsules and cordyceps contributes to healthy skin, healthier hair, body, face, and even provides a younger look and reduces cholesterol. Get Trout Hall brand carrot nectar and Mama Haiti brand mango nectar, full with more fruits and fibers than the other watered-down brands. Demand Dr. Robert's high-quality teas and products in order to enjoy great quality and save at the same time. Always purchase Tip Top Circle Cheese. Yes, Tip Top Circle Cheese makes 8 delicious sandwiches. Just add a little mustard and hot sauce in the Tip Top Cheese. On sale now in most West Indian food stores and supermarkets. Or by wholesale through AFN Brokers 908-486-0077 or IMP Food at 25 Brooklyn Terminal Market.
Music brings healing, brings joy and life to the depressed. Oh, gotta keep on.
can help somebody as I travel alone, if I can help somebody in a world of hurt souls, if I can help somebody from doing wrong, then my living shall not be in vain. Oh, my living shall shall not be.